Hello guys, Assalamu alaikum. So today we are going to learn how to install Docker on Windows 10. First of all, what is Docker? If we talk about our previous VMware structure, where we were using multiple VMs for different applications to run on separate VM. So in that case, we have to install operating system on each machine and then running that application over there. So there was another problem that sometimes you're facing some issues in lower environment and in production staging. We are having a different kind of issues. So to address all these situations, where we can save operating system resources on, and also to save these bugs or errors in different environments. This Docker environment or container platform is introduced where we can run our application on containers, which are basically just running on single operating system, but all the containers are separate with each other. But so in that case, we are also achieving this goal that our application, which is running on lower environment, is the same replica running on the production. So there are less chances that there is anything which can impact services in production, not in development environment. So this was just brief, and let's take a look how we can install Docker and take advantage of that. Let's go to this first link and check out like if there's any installer available. Okay, download from Docker Hub. All right, so we are going to download Docker for Windows. So here it is. Download Docker desktop for Windows. So if we click on that, the download will start. So I have already downloaded this, and close this and go to download folder. I just need to run this. When we are installing Docker, what it will do, it will start installing all the packages and pull some. It will set up our environment variables and also service, Windows service, so that if that service is running, then it means our Docker is should be running. But if that service is stopped, so we cannot access our Docker because everything is running through that service. So we can run this Docker without service, but as this is recommended to use default service configuration for Windows. So in other case, you have to start all the pieces with the specified pattern. So let's install this quickly. I'm going to pause this video. In the meantime, it is going to install. Okay, now installation is completed. So before running commands, what I will do, I have to check if Docker service is running. Let's go to services and check this out. Okay, Docker service is running, and then we have to go to Docker desktop application. And once we launch it, our Docker application desktop will start running. So we can see here one icon is there. Desktop Docker is starting. Once it will start, it will give me window to sign in my Docker Hub. If you want to sign in, you can. So in that case, you can save all your work directly to your repo, which you can create. This is the first time, that's why it is taking time, so later it will not take much time. I guess my system is also responding slow. Okay, let me stop the video for some time. Okay, now this window is open once it is started, so I can use my Docker Hub username and password to sign in this one. If you don't have that, don't worry, it is running now. So what you can do, you can run PowerShell with an administrator to access. If you're not running this without administrator, then you may face error in running commands. So here we have all the information: the Docker install and its server version is 19.03. Storage driver is this overlay. So overlay means like it is basically coordinating with the system storage and container storage. So this is, we can say, mount point where our Windows storage is mapped. Okay, now here I can run the command Docker PS. It will give me all the containers running on this Docker setup. So let me pull one image. Docker pull hello world. So it is using the latest tag. It means we are pulling this hello world from the Docker Hub and pull its latest version. If we want to specify any older version, then we have to mention that, okay, version this needs to be installed. Let me pause this again. Okay, it took a little while. So here we can see if I'm running this minus A, so it will be showing me all the continue.